it's me, and today we're gonna be checking out some very cheap people. Y'all remember this woman, right?
My name is Amy Elizabeth, and I'm the world's cheapest multimillionaire.
Multimillionaire!
With a personal net worth of $5.3 million.
She's worth over $5 million, and chooses to be cheap. She was the one making her friends and family cat food instead of tuna.
I came to her house, she asked me, did I want lunch? So I said, sure. She fixed me a tuna fish sandwich. As I'm eating the sandwich, I'm thinking, this is a little fishy.
You think? Fed her friend little cat food straight out the can and into the buns.
This is my one sponge. Some people might think this is a little nasty. Until it's falling apart and rotting, I don't see any reason to throw it away.
She's not gonna throw away her sponge until it has literal mold. She start washing her dishes, and then a mold crumb comes off, and then she eat off of it, get food poisoning. I guess it's time to buy a new sponge. Ah, my bank account gonna take a real hit with this one. You know, if only I could just go to the dollar store and buy four for a dollar. But no, I can't afford my lifestyle if I did that.
Over here, I have one knife. I guard it with my life. It never touches water. I just wipe it down on a towel every time after I use it and put it back in the drawer.
Oh, that's her officer? She's the person that cuts an apple and it tastes like onion. She don't wash her knife. Homie, you can't live like that. That's nasty. Like, you're telling me you cut raw meat, wipe that bad boy off, and you're good to cut strawberries and bananas? No. That is a crime.
So the way I got the house is when my ex-husband and I decided to divorce, he's got a good heart and he insisted that I keep the house because he knew that if I didn't keep the house, I would move into a hovel of a one-bedroom apartment.
Her husband gave her the house. Tell me you've never worked a day in your life without telling me you've never worked a day in your life. Oh, she just told me. Oh, honey, it's okay. I paid off the house, but like, you can have it. Here you go. Self-made, millionaire, cheapskate, girl boss.
Amy won't pay anyone to clean her home. So her ex-husband volunteers to do it for free, saving her $400 a month.
I'm sorry, what? The world's biggest simp over here. Ex-husband. I'm such a nice guy. I gave my ex-wife my house. And every week, get this, he comes over and cleans it. Where can I find one of those?
And do the toilet? That needs it the worst.
Be honest, did you do something horrible to her and you feel the need to be nice to her the rest of her life? There is something going on here.
And don't forget to get under the rim because you miss that a lot.
I'm glad to help her around the house with the cleaning. I do yard work.
Landscaping too. She's saving so much money off this guy. I have nothing to do all day. I'm gonna go clean my ex-wife's house. And while I'm at it, I'll do her landscaping too. Trim her bushes, you know, anything. As long as I can get close enough to smell her. This dude is something else.
This is like free exercise for him. Keeps him in shape. Win, win, win all the way around.
Alrighty. Mutually beneficial relationship. He gets his exercise, she gets her work done. Anyways, she got a little competition because TLC found another one.
Victoria is the only millionaire that I know that dumpster dives.
She's a millionaire. What's the point of even having money if you keep living like this? It's like a homeless person having thousands of dollars and they're like, ah, you know what? I like being homeless. I'ma just live under this tree rent free the rest of my life. Actually, I'm sure there are people like that. But like, come on, you're getting old. Don't you wanna like spend the money? Buy a red convertible or something. So when her boyfriend moved in, he brought a microwave with him. And this is what this psycho had to say.
I want you to just try to see things from my point of view. And so your job is to figure out how much it costs to cook a frozen dinner in this microwave.
Oh my goodness.
Sorry, what? Let me call the electric company. Hey, yo, how much electricity is it gonna be to cook a frozen burrito for 90 seconds? How would they even know? Unless it's the only electricity that you get. And then every time you microwave something, I want you to tally how long it's been and how much it cost me in electricity. And then I want you to reimburse me for the electricity. I'd rather just move out. I am done with this. Even prisoners don't have to do that.
I need you to start peeing in a bottle for me.
Sorry, what? As weird as it sounds, this is a common trend among these cheapskates. When you flush the toilet, not only are you flushing your dookie, you are flushing money down the drain. My dad also used to do that. Like, I'ma go like 4, 5, 6, 7 times before I flush the toilet. Saves money, but at what cost? She's a millionaire, but still refuses to flush her toilet.
Please?
She said, please, though.
No.
He said, no.
It's not that big a deal.
I'm really not that interested in peeing in a box.
This is extreme. I know you've been peeing in a toilet your entire life, but now, at 50-something years old, it's time to change. You're gonna start doing it in a bottle because I want to save $1 a month.
Would you please do it? To help save money.
Oh, she said to help save money. I'd rather contribute to the bills and keep my normal toilet habit. I swear these people will do anything to save money except work. Work another hour, make more money, prevent the piss problems.
There's no difference, yeah. You're standing at the toilet, you're either going in this vestibule or this vestibule.
Then we could poop in a bucket too, and then we could just take the toilet clear out.
All right.
Just get rid of the toilet, you know, just replace it with a bucket. We're gonna be living like the caveman. You wanna play this game? Let's go all out. Bucket or no deal.
So I'm in the kitchen cooking. I've realized, wow, he's taking a long shower. Oh my goodness. I hear money going down the drain.
She sounds like my dad. The water running. You hear that? That is my bank account being drained by the second. We're gonna end up on the streets because our boyfriend decided to take a shower for more than 3.5 minutes. She's going down.
I don't wanna
set
the stage so he just comes over and takes these long showers.
Was long to her, 5 minutes. She turned off the water. Didn't you just say you were cooking in the kitchen? You turned off water for the entire house because your boyfriend, who lives with you and probably contributes to the rent, has had the water on for more than 2.5 minutes. Ma'am, you are crazy.
Did you turn the water off?
Yeah. You're like so thick-headed. I made my point, didn't I?
Okay, that isn't the right way to prove a point. Yeah, turn the water back on.
Did I make it though?
No. You didn't make any point at all.
I turned the water on.
You just pissed me off.
My dude still got soap in his hair. I had to cause problems and ruin a relationship in 3, 2, 1. Showering? Just turn off the water. Are you using the Wi-Fi past 9 p.m.? Pull the plug. For the cheapos, the shower time, very sacred. So she sets a timer for her water heater to heat up so she knows when the water will be warm and then turns off her shower.
My handy dandy water heater timer. I set it for 22 minutes so I know exactly when my shower is ready because God forbid I waste an extra minute on that water heater. It saves me over $80 a month on my water bill.
$80 a month? It saves you $80 a month? I feel like your water bill should be around $80 a month. If you're one person, you can't bamboozle me.
All right, what is this again?
That's carrots.
All right, so this is the burdock.
Yes.
You know it's bad when her boyfriend has to critique her cooking, like, what is this? What did you put in the food? I know you did not wash your hands before making this because you turned off the water. Ugh. Ugh.
The flavor is like...
Good thing we're eating outside. Throw it into the good old compost pile. My girlfriend's bad cooking keeps me in shape. Hard to gain weight when you spit out half the food. I'm more interested in dessert.
This is from a local bakery. I'm almost hesitant to tell you the history of this cake.
Oh my God.
What is this?
She dumpster dove for the cake that she is serving her friends? Ma'am, you are nasty. I would have left right then and there. Suddenly, I'm not hungry. Like, if you want to dumpster dive for your baked goods, go on right ahead. But like, don't feed it to other people.
This out of the dumpster.
The kid like.
How do you know that it's not like it messed
wrapped.
Up?
It was wrapped, completely, untouched. Wrapped. Topping is my own invention. Pureed wild strawberries from my garden.
Did you wash them thoroughly?
Listen.
She did not wash them. She turned off the water while she was cooking. I'm calling her out right then and there. It don't matter if they washed. I grew them. They organic, locally grown. If a fly wanna land on the strawberries, then we got 24/7 slap security on those. Stop questioning the safety of my food.
I'm gonna pass on dumpster cake. Really not my thing.
Smart guy.
I've had much more dangerous thing. My mother is really passionate about what she does, and so what if I get a little bit of diarrhea?
Oh, that's his mom? You feeding your kids this? I don't know if I should give her the pass. So she's surprising her boyfriend with a vacuum.
You can open your eyes now. I can give this to Steve as like a gesture or a token of like welcome to our house together.
Let me guess, dumpster?
Yeah, people like put things by the dumpsters and they don't put it in the dumpster.
I don't know which is worse. Her putting a vacuum from the dumpster on the dining table? That's gross. What are you doing? Do you lick your hand after wiping as well?
This is my beautiful home. As you can see, it's full of upscale furniture. I like nice things, but I don't like to pay for them.
Amy works hard to stay well below a $1,000 monthly budget.
Okay, we get it. You have a decent house. But man, what is that fridge? You are worth over $5 million. And she probably brought the same fridge from when she was growing up. What is this?
Do not disrespect my fridge. It has a water and an ice dispenser.
Whoa, excuse me.
And although she can't afford a more comfortable lifestyle, she saves more than $200,000 annually by refusing to buy anything new.
So that's how she became a multimillionaire. Just don't spend money. Don't buy anything new. But anyways, that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys enjoyed and want more cheapskate videos, make sure you hit that like button in the face.
And make sure you turn on notifications.
Click.
Click.
And subscribe to the Wolf Pack. Ow! I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.